I think in the short term, you know, there will be some dislocation that will happen, right? Because capital has to find ways to get deployed, right? And so it will go where there is opportunities. And so so other markets, not just India, but other markets will also benefit from that focus, right? So all of those will benefit. And it's not like India wasn't getting attention, right? India was getting a lot of investment. I think you're all very aware what happened in the first 6 months in terms of the amount of capital flowing into the country. So it was happening even before anything happened in China. The impact of China will be there across all other geographies. Ultimately, capital is going to go where the opportunities are there. So there'll be a lot of it flowing into Southeast Asia. You know, the China saga has, you know, completely played out. We are just seeing kind of a snapshot in between. And, you know, and I don't think it's going to end there. They will actually figure out a way in which there'll be a new equilibrium that will come. Right. I don't think they'll want to be something they're so unfriendly to investors. I don't think that is where it's going to settle. Right. So there'll be a new equilibrium that will happen and then it'll again become friendly to investors. I think that's what's going to happen even in China. See, ultimately, it's not about country. It is about individual opportunities. Right. So people are going and investing in companies, not countries. Right. So you know, and wherever those good companies are, you know, capital will flow there. And India happens to have a very good ecosystem of good companies, which is why it will have, you know, that share of capital.